Alright guys, third time should be the charm. I was listening to the audio playback on Let's Destroy Part 12, and while it was picking up... Wow, it's really funny now, but if you guys listen to it, but in the background behind my own commentary, were crazy loud sirens. And that's compliments of the Oshkosh, Wisconsin emergency task team. So, they were just outside doing whatever. But this is the gym battle versus Whitney. First one's a Clea Fairy, level 18. Not a big threat. I burped away from the mic, so if you still heard it, sorry. Next is a Miltank, level 20. Hiccup. Now, oh dang, I have the hiccups. Now, Attract is the most evil of all moves because, oh jeez, that was loud. Alright, we'll just watch this. I'm gonna get rid of my hiccups. I just use the hold your breath method, so sorry if you guys missed out on my lovely commentary. But this is the Clea Modal Surf, Clea Lava I was talking about. As you'll see, this flame wheel, which I'm in love with. But Attract, not really the greatest move unless you know which gender your opponent's Pokemon are going to be. That was what was trying to get out. I had to yawn. The deal with Attract is, if a Pokemon uses Attract on you, you become infatuated. And that means that you have a 50% chance of attacking that Pokemon. So, every time I try to attack, the game decides to flip a coin. And if it lands on heads, I get to attack. If it lands on tails, I don't get to attack. Which works to my disadvantage. I was actually just looking in my bag to see if I had an X defend, and I don't. I only have X attack. So we just go for our guns and keep hammering on with Flame Wheel. I was glad that that paralysis happened because that let me get another attack in without taking damage or using a potion. But pretty much that's Whitney. Will by far not be the fastest gym leader ever. I'm going to say right now Bugsy was the fastest just because of that loadout. For whoever was asking, I think I commented back, but Bugsy is a boy. And I sent you a link to a video of the fight with Bugsy. But here's a crazy 215. I'm not going to postpone the evolution of Flaffy because, well, look at that. It's Ampharos, the most BA electric type there is. And plus when you let it evolve, it as an Ampharos, it learns Thunder Punch, which I want. So, Thunder Punch, because it's an electric type, has a special attack setting. So we're going to get rid of Headbutt. Well, eventually we will. I was trying to decide what to get rid of, but Headbutt is definitely the choice. So 1-2, poof, crazy 15 for that Headbutt, and landing Thunder Punch. Thunder Punch, pretty good move. I'm not going to lie, I enjoy it. So what happens is you walk away from Whitney, and she's crying, and then her friend says, well, you made Whitney cry, and don't make the mistake of keeping and walking away thinking you have the plane badge, because you don't. you don't have it. You have to go back to her and talk to her again to get it. But, oh man, lost my train of thought. Man, I hope the audio on this one turns out really good. Man, I hate having crappy audio. I thought about teaching my motosurf Swift, but then I decided not to because I like the attacks that it has. But since now that we beat Whitney, we can move out. Whitney's badge lets us use the HM move Strength, which we won't need for a while. But we can use it. So whenever we happen to need Strength, we'll be able to use it. I don't like that this game is ordered weird. Like, the HMs you can use for when you need to battle are like backwards. You know, it's like Flash, Cut, you know, the normal first two, and then Strength, which we won't use for a while. And then after Strength, we have Surf, Fly, and then Whirlpool, and then Waterfall. So, you know, whichever. So first question was, do you have to pay for a bike? No. Can you get a Charmander in the game corner? Yes. What do we say to pirates? No. Can you get a Mudkip in Union Cave? Yes, even though I haven't gotten one yet. And he gives you the Radio Visible. Now, this item I don't think is important until you get to Kanto, when you have to wake up the Snorlax. But just for the sake, I'll show it off. There it is. It looks like the TGP. So, that's that. This guy, I don't understand what his deal is with this game or whatnot. You spend 300 Poké Dollars and you play a game that you can't control. It's like the game picks it, and then whatever ball you get, I guess, determines a prize. And this lady's just the token greeter. Oh, man. So tired and bored. This is the game corner. This is where you can get your Charmander if you want. I'll show Pokemon from here. 13 Charmander and Larvitar. I miss the wind coming through my window. But anyway, I tried to buy enough coins to get a Larvitar, and well, let's just say I don't have enough. But after we leave the game corner, go over to the house in here, and she'll give you the squirt bottle, which you'll need. It's very important. Very, very important. And she just tells you about the moving tree, that we're going to go and win against. But so this is a tree rock in the road. Everybody's talking about this tree, this crazy, wriggly tree that is blocking the road. Well, we're gonna go fight it. Here's another Yanma. You've seen them already. So I skipped the battle. Pretty simple. I'm still carrying around Emo Queen, so we'll use Cut. The north. East. Through the weeds. And this is that wriggly tree that we're talking about. So you use the squirt bottle on it, and it says it doesn't like the squirt bottle. Well, this wriggly tree is actually a Sudowoodo. You would think it's a grass type, and so many people think that it's grass when they first fight it because it's a wriggly tree. Well, Sudowoodo is actually a rock type, just plain up rock. So I used my Thunder Punch against it because rock gets normal damage from Thunder Punch, so I wasn't too worried. So here's where the apricorn is supposed to grow. Here's a black apricorn. Now I thought because I got the first one right, these other two would have something, but they don't. Now I could run all the way back to Azalea Town, give Kurt the apricorn, continue on my journey, and then go get it later, and see what kind of Pokeball I got, but I'm not going to do it. So here's a Houndour. So if you picked Totodile or Chikorita, Houndour is a pretty good fire dark type you can pick. So, Definitely will be good in the next gym if you decide to pick it. We're gonna skip that double trainer because I don't feel like fighting it. And we're gonna fight the single trainer up here. I really just wanted to get to Ecruteak City by the end of this video, just so, you know, I'm making a pretty even pace. I'm not sure if I'm skipping a lot of side quests. I don't know if anyone really has a walkthrough for this game. It'd be nice if they did, or if Zell put one out. That'd be really nice to have a walkthrough for this game. But here's Ecruteak City. Now, one of the new things that Zell added for Ecruteak City is that it's raining. But the first place you should go in Ecruteak City is in here, and this is the Kimono Dance Studio, where they dance. So we'll end here and pick up with the Kimono Sister Battles on the next video. Comment, subscribe, send messages. See you next time.